Hi, I'm Savannah Walbert, and these are a couple of my highlights from Blue Tech Week. One of the sessions on Wednesday of this year's Blue Tech Week was called Autonomous and Fleet Vessel Management. This session was focused on a huge variety of different applications for autonomous vessels in the ocean. The first speaker during this session was the CEO of the company D-Ice, which is on the cutting edge of developing autonomous commercial shipping systems. He spoke specifically about a lot of their weather-related safety measures, which can take storm prediction models and incorporate them into planning for an autonomous shipping fleet. Safety is an extremely complicated aspect of autonomous vehicles, and it's one of the major hurdles that needs to be conquered before autonomous shipping fleets become reality. The next speaker in the session was the co-founder of Dot Ocean, which is a company that makes complex autonomous systems and sediment profilers. They program systems to control autonomous vehicles for a wide variety of different uses, and the complexity of their systems are pretty far beyond the average autonomous vehicle. The system that controls their vehicles is able to continuously incorporate new data coming in through a wireless connection to what they call an intelligent cloud platform, so that the system can continuously change its goals or how it tries to reach those goals based on any number of different factors. The next speaker was the Chief Commercial Officer for Sea Machine Robotics, which is a leader in the industry of autonomous vehicles for both the commercial and defense industries. Their vision is to build the future of ocean mobility. Essentially, they are also trying to incorporate autonomous control into the worldwide shipping fleet. The Chief Innovation Officer for IO Currents then spoke about his company's work, which focuses on automating the processes that actually happen on board the ship, rather than the control and steering of the whole ship. For instance, he talked about their system to automate record keeping on ships, which would take that burden off a ship worker who likely would be exhausted from physical labor. Automating this process could really help to reduce a lot of human error that happens in the record keeping on these ships. The next session I watched on Wednesday was the on and offshore freshwater session. The first speaker was the sales manager for Astera North America, which is an organization that works towards making field investigation teams more effective, which immediately jumped out at me as really interesting. For instance, they have been able to effectively double the rate at which field teams can find leaks in water pipes. One of the things they are really focusing on right now is searching for fresh water using satellite sensing technology. They are able to take data from satellites and actually use it to tell field teams where to search for access to clean water in the ground, which I thought was really impressive and surprising. All of these are really good examples of how automated technology can help jobs get done more accurately and much more efficiently than ever before. The final speaker I got to listen to on Wednesday was the CEO of Marine Tech, which is another company exploring natural freshwater springs. These freshwater springs often produce fresh water at extremely high rates to the point that local communities could benefit significantly from utilizing that fresh water. He went over their entire process, beginning with the discovery and confirmation of freshwater spring, then moving into advanced analysis and observation of that spring. All aspects of the spring are considered to determine if it has all the right physical qualities to make extracting fresh water from it viable. They also analyze the local economy and see exactly how this operation would fit into that dynamic system. Engineering studies are completed as well as design studies. Finally, collecting units can be installed and connected to the water supply to put the plan into motion. Finding and utilizing relatively accessible sources of fresh water like these springs is extremely important right now. We are constantly running lower and lower on fresh water, so any and all environmentally sound methods of collecting fresh water are really important for the planet, which is why this presentation really jumped out at me as significant. Overall, it seems like autonomous marine systems are advancing at a pretty incredible rate. Some of the things these companies are able to do with autonomous systems, as well as the types of data they are able to incorporate into those systems, is really mind-blowing. I want to just finish up by thanking CSUCI's IRA committee, as well as the ESRM 462 Coastal Management class, for letting us attend Blue Tech Week. Thank you.